Dear students, in this lecture of differential calculus, we will do algebra of limits. If limit x approaches to a, function fx is L, and for another function gx, limit x approaches to a is m, then under the sum rule, limit of x tend to a fx plus gx will be equal to L plus m. Difference rule says that limit x approaches to a fx minus gx is equal to L minus m. According to product rule, limit x approaches to a fx into gx is equal to L into m. Number 4 is the constant multiplication rule that says that limit x approaches to a k into fx will be equal to k into L. Fifth is the quotient rule, that is limit x approaches to a fx upon gx is equal to L upon m, provided that m is not equal to 0. Now we will prove these rules one by one. First is the sum rule, which states that the limit of sum of two functions is the sum of their limits. We are given that limit x approaches to a fx is L, and limit x approaches to a gx is equal to m. According to epsilon delta definition of limit, for the first limit of function fx, there exists a positive real delta 1 depending upon epsilon such that mod fx minus L is less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta 1. And limit of x tend to a gx is equal to m by epsilon delta definition. For given epsilon greater than 0, however small, there exists delta 2 depending upon epsilon such that mod gx minus m less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta 2. Now we want to use these conditions together. That means we are to find such a value of delta which serves the purpose for delta 1 as well as delta 2. Therefore, we define delta to be the minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. Therefore, first condition becomes mod fx minus L less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta. And this second condition becomes mod gx minus m less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta. Now, we want to prove that limit of sum of function is equal to the sum of the limit values L plus m. Therefore, we start from here mod fx plus gx minus L plus m. So, taking fx minus L in one bracket plus taking gx minus m in second bracket. This is the mod function. Apply triangular inequality on this. So this says that mod of this function fx minus L plus gx minus m by triangular inequality is less than equal to mod fx minus L plus mod gx minus m. From the last slide, we have seen that mod fx minus L is less than epsilon by 2 and mod gx minus m is also less than epsilon by 2. Adding these two, we get epsilon value here, and which is true for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta. Remember, we have defined delta as the minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. So here we have proved that mod fx plus gx minus L plus m is less than epsilon for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta. Therefore, by the epsilon delta definition of limit, we obtain limit x approaches to a fx plus gx is equal to L plus m. This proves the sum rule. Next is number 2, difference rule. We want to prove that the limit of difference of two functions is the difference of their limits. Again, using the epsilon delta definition for limit of function fx and limit of function gx. Right, here we are applying the epsilon delta definition of limits. For function fx, first limit, we have chosen delta 1 constant. For the second limit of gx, we have chosen second constant delta 2. We want to use these two conditions together and this is possible by defining value of delta as the minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. And these two results are rewritten as this: mod fx minus l less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta, and mod gx minus m less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta. Now we want to prove that the limit of difference of the functions, that is mod fx minus gx, is the difference of the limit, that is equal to l minus m. So we start by mod of fx minus gx minus l minus m, taking fx minus l in one bracket and gx minus m in second bracket. Apply triangular inequality, we obtain that this is mod less than equal to mod fx minus l plus mod gx minus m. As we have seen in the last slide, mod fx minus l is less than epsilon by 2 and mod gx minus m is also less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a is less than delta, where delta is defined as the minimum value of delta 1 and delta 2. So here we obtain that mod fx minus gx minus l minus m is less than epsilon whenever 0 less than mod x minus a is less than delta. Therefore, by epsilon delta definition of limits, we obtain limit x tends to a fx minus gx is equal to l minus m. Next is to prove the limit of product of two functions. We will prove that limit of fx is l, limit of gx is equal to m, then limit of fx into gs as x approaches to a is equal to l into m. So, given limit of function fx x tend to a is equal to l, applying epsilon delta definition of limit of function, we obtain of mod fx minus l less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta 1. We are given that limit x approaches to a gx is equal to m. So, we obtain mod gx minus m less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta 2. Let us define delta as the minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. Delta is the value which serves the purpose for delta 1 and delta 2. These two inequalities will be satisfied for the common value delta. Therefore, these results become mod fx minus l less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta, and mod gx minus m is less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta. Now, we know that limit x tend to a fx is equal to l. And by epsilon delta definition, there exists positive real delta depending upon epsilon, such that mod fx minus l less than epsilon by 2 for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta, right? So, function fx has limit l, and in the last lecture, lecture 2 of differential calculus, we have seen that whenever limit of fx is x tend to a is l, then function fx is bounded in the deleted neighborhood of a. So, if it is bounded in the deleted neighborhood of a, this means there exists a positive real number k such that mod fx will be less than k for 0 less than mod x minus a is less than delta dash. Now, we choose delta double dash as the minimum of delta and delta dash because we want to use the previous three conditions together. For the first value of delta 1 and delta 2, we have chosen the common value delta. In the last slides, we have chosen delta as the minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. And now we have, from the bounded condition of fx, we are also getting another constant delta dash, right? But now we want to use the common value of delta and delta dash. For this purpose, we have to define minimum of delta and delta dash is equal to delta double dash, so that all the values delta 1, delta 2 and delta dash conditions can be used together here. So start by mod fx gx minus l into m. Here subtract m into fx, add m into fx here, right? Then look at carefully, here we take fx as common, we write gx minus m in bracket, from these two terms we take m common here, so fx minus l is here. Next step, apply triangular inequality, we get this less than equal to mod fx mod gx minus m plus mod of m mod of fx minus l. As fx is bounded, so mod fx is less than k. We have seen in the last slide that mod fx is less than k, and this condition was true for delta dash, right? But here we have defined delta double dash as the minimum of delta and delta dash. Therefore, this condition is also satisfied for delta double dash, which is the minimum of delta and delta dash. So mod fx is less than k, and gx mod gx minus m, which is less than epsilon by 2, this condition is satisfied for the delta neighborhood, therefore also for delta double dash, and plus mod m, and mod fx minus l is also less than epsilon by 2. From here we take epsilon common, so writing this value as epsilon dash, so we obtain mod fx gx minus lm is less than epsilon dash. And in what neighborhood of A? In the delta double dash neighborhood of A. Therefore, mod fx gx minus lm is less than epsilon dash for 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta double dash, where delta dash double dash was defined as minimum of delta and delta dash. Therefore, epsilon delta definition says that limit x approaches to A fx into gx is equal to l into m. Next, we will prove that the limit of a constant times of function is that constant times of the limit of function. We are given that limit of fx is l as x approaches to A. This is the epsilon delta definition of limit of functions. So we want to prove that limit of k fx is equal to kl as x approaches to A. So we will start from mod k fx minus kl. Taking mod k common from here, it is mod k mod fx minus l. But mod fx minus l is less than epsilon, therefore this is less than mod k into epsilon. Write mod k into epsilon as epsilon dash, right? And this is true in the delta neighborhood of A. Therefore, mod k fx minus kl is less than epsilon dash whenever 0 less than mod x minus a is less than delta. So, by epsilon delta definition of limit of function, limit x approaches to a k into fx is equal to kl. Next is the fifth rule, that is the limit of quotient of two functions is the quotient of their limits provided that denominator is not equal to 0. Now here we are given that limit of gx x approaches to a is equal to m. Let us define epsilon is equal to mod m by 2, right? And we can find a positive real number delta 1 such that mod gx minus m is less than epsilon, and epsilon is chosen as mod m by 2 for this delta 1 neighborhood of A. Now start by mod m, subtract gx and add gx here, right? So this becomes, here it should be less than equal to, applying triangular inequality here, it is less than equal to mod gx minus m plus mod gx, make a correction here, it should be less than equal to, so this is less than equal to mod gx minus m plus mod gx. Here mod gx minus m is less than mod m by 2, so this is less than mod m by 2 plus mod gx. From here we get mod m less than mod m by 2 plus mod gx. Taking mod gx on one side, we get mod gx is greater than mod m by 2 for this neighborhood, 0 less than mod x minus a less than delta 1. So this is the condition we will use in the proof of this theorem. Now start here by mod fx by gx minus l by m, because we want to prove that limit extend to a fx upon gx is equal to l upon m. So here this we get mfx minus lgx upon mgx by taking LCM, and here in the numerator part subtract ml, add ml, right? From the first two terms taking m common, from the last two terms taking l common, right? So this becomes less than equal to mod m mod fx minus l plus mod l mod gx minus m. That is again by using triangular inequality for this term, for the numerator term. In the denominator we have mod m mod gx, right? Now this separate these two terms. Here we get mod m cancels with this, we get mod fx minus l upon mod gx. In the second term we get mod l mod gx minus m upon mod m mod gx, right? Now we have seen in the last slide that mod gx is greater than mod m by 2. Therefore 1 upon mod gx will be less than 2 upon mod m. So here we have 1 upon gx which is less than 2 upon mod m. Mod fx minus l is written as it is. Here mod l mod gx minus m is written as it is. Mod gx is less than 2 upon mod m, mod m square. So it becomes 2 upon mod m square. Therefore start from here, mod fx upon gx minus lm is less than 2 upon mod m fx minus l plus 2 upon mod m square mod l mod gx minus m for delta 1 neighborhood of A. As limit of fx x approaches to A is l, we can choose some delta 2 depending upon epsilon such that mod fx minus l is less than epsilon mod m upon 4 for delta 2 neighborhood of A. Because gx limit is m, there exists a positive real number delta 3 such that mod gx minus m is less than this value epsilon by 4 mod m square upon l for delta 3 neighborhood of A. So why we are choosing these values of epsilon like this? We are choosing these values because at the end of this result, we want to make this mod value, mod of fx upon gx minus l upon m, we want to make this less than epsilon, so that epsilon delta definition of limits can be applied. So if you go to this slide, here we are getting mod fx gx minus l upon m less than 2 by mod m, which is constant value, into mod fx minus l. Here I have sum of two terms, right? So if I get this value to be less than epsilon by 2 and this value to be less than epsilon by 2, then in total it will give that mod fx upon gx minus l upon m will be less than epsilon, right? So now I want to make this value to be less than epsilon by 2. How is it possible? This is possible if I define mod fx minus l to be less than epsilon upon mod by 4, so that when you put it here 2, 4 cancels and here mod m cancel, and it will give you epsilon by 2 here. Similarly, for the second term, here we have 2 mod l upon mod m square into mod gx minus m. So I want to choose such a value of mod gx minus m less than some epsilon, so that this term also becomes less than epsilon by 2. So that is why we choose mod gx minus m less than epsilon by 4 mod m square upon l for the delta 3 neighborhood of A. So now writing this and this together, we obtain this plus this. The first term less than epsilon by 2 and the second term also less than epsilon by 2, which in total gives you epsilon. Therefore, mod fx upon gx minus l by m becomes less than epsilon whenever 0 less than mod x minus a is less than delta. So, by epsilon delta definition of limits, we obtain that limit x tend to a fx upon gx is equal to l by m, provided that m is not equal to 0. And you know that if m becomes 0, this limit will not be defined. That is it for today. Thank you very much.